Neutron stars are some of the most fascinating and extreme objects in the universe. These incredibly dense, compact remnants of massive stars are only a few miles in diameter but contain a mass greater than that of the Sun. Neutron stars are thought to be formed when a massive star runs out of fuel and undergoes a supernova explosion, leaving behind a dense, collapsed core made up mostly of neutrons. Properties of neutron stars. Neutron stars have some unique properties that make them stand out in the cosmos. One of the most striking features is their extreme density. Neutron stars are so dense that a teaspoon of neutron star material would weigh as much as a mountain on Earth. This is because the neutrons in the core are squeezed together so tightly that they essentially merge into one giant atomic nucleus. Another important property of neutron stars is their strong magnetic fields. Neutron stars are thought to have the strongest magnetic fields in the universe, trillions of times stronger than Earth's magnetic field. These magnetic fields can produce intense radiation and create spectacular phenomena, such as pulsars and magnetars. Pulsars are rapidly spinning neutron stars that emit beams of radiation from their magnetic poles. As the neutron star rotates, these beams sweep across the sky like a lighthouse beacon, producing regular pulses of radiation that can be detected by telescopes on Earth. Pulsars were first discovered in the 1960s and have since been used as incredibly precise cosmic clocks, helping scientists to study the properties of gravity and the nature of the universe. Magnetars. Magnetars are a type of neutron star with an even stronger magnetic field than pulsars. These objects are thought to be the most magnetized objects in the universe and can produce intense bursts of X-rays and gamma rays. Magnetars are also thought to be responsible for so-called fast radio bursts, mysterious radio signals that originate from beyond our galaxy. Detection of neutron stars. Neutron stars can be detected through a variety of methods. Pulsars, as mentioned earlier, emit beams of radiation that can be detected by radio telescopes on Earth. The intense radiation emitted by magnetars can also be detected across the electromagnetic spectrum, from X-rays to gamma rays. In addition to direct observations, neutron stars can also be detected indirectly through their effects on their surroundings. For example, the strong gravity of a neutron star can cause a nearby companion star to orbit it in a very tight, elliptical orbit. This can cause the companion star to periodically eclipse the neutron star, allowing astronomers to measure the size and properties of the neutron star indirectly. Conclusion: neutron stars are some of the most extreme and fascinating objects in the universe. Their extreme density and magnetic fields can produce spectacular phenomena, such as pulsars and magnetars, that can be studied using a variety of techniques. Neutron stars provide a unique laboratory for studying the properties of matter under extreme conditions and offer insights into the nature of the universe as a whole. Asteroids are small, rocky objects that orbit the Sun. They are thought to be remnants from the formation of the solar system, which occurred about 4.6 billion years ago. While most asteroids are located in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, some can come close to Earth and pose a potential threat to our planet. Composition and types of asteroids. Asteroids are composed of various materials, including rock, metal, and ice. Some asteroids are made up primarily of nickel and iron, similar to the Earth's core, while others are made up of carbon-rich materials, such as graphite and organic compounds. The composition of asteroids can tell us about the conditions in the early solar system and provide clues about the formation and evolution of planets. There are several different types of asteroids based on their composition and location in the solar system. C-type asteroids are the most common type and are composed of carbon-rich materials. S-type asteroids are composed of silicate minerals, while M-type asteroids are made up primarily of nickel and iron. Impact hazard and mitigation. While most asteroids pose no threat to Earth, some can come close enough to potentially cause damage or destruction. The impact of an asteroid with a diameter of 1 kilometer or greater could have global consequences, including a catastrophic climate change event. Fortunately, scientists are working to identify potentially hazardous asteroids and develop strategies to mitigate the impact risk. This includes searching for asteroids using ground-based telescopes and space-based observatories, as well as developing technologies to deflect or destroy asteroids before they reach Earth. Exploration and mining. Asteroids also have the potential to be valuable resources for space exploration and commercial activities. Some asteroids contain significant amounts of water and other volatiles, which could be used to sustain human colonies on other planets. Additionally, asteroids could be mined for their valuable metals, such as platinum, which are rare on Earth. Several missions have been launched to study asteroids up close, including NASA's OSIRIS-REx mission, which successfully collected a sample from the asteroid Bennu in 2020. These missions provide valuable information about the composition and properties of asteroids and could pave the way for future exploration and mining activities. Comets are icy, small solar system bodies that orbit the Sun. They are sometimes called dirty snowballs because of their composition, which consists of ice, dust, and other materials. Comets are believed to be remnants from the formation of the solar system, and their study can provide insight into the early history of our solar system. Composition and types of comets. Comets are composed of a nucleus, coma, and tail. The nucleus is the solid, central part of the comet that is made up of rock, dust, and frozen gases, including water, carbon dioxide, and methane. The coma is a gas and dust envelope that surrounds the nucleus and can extend for millions of kilometers. The tail is composed of ionized gas and dust that is blown away from the coma by solar wind. There are two types of comets, short-period comets and long-period comets. Short-period comets have orbits that take them around the Sun in less than 200 years and are thought to originate from the Kuiper Belt, a region of the solar system beyond Neptune that is home to many icy objects. Long-period comets have orbits that take them around the Sun in more than 200 years and are thought to originate from the Oort cloud, a hypothetical region of the solar system beyond the Kuiper Belt that is believed to be home to a large number of comets. Observation and study. Comets are often visible to the naked eye and have been observed for thousands of years. They can be studied using ground-based telescopes and space-based observatories, including NASA's Deep Impact mission, which successfully collided a probe with the comet Tempel 1 in 2005 to study its composition. Comet exploration has also been undertaken by several spacecraft, including NASA's Stardust mission, which returned samples of the coma and tail of the comet Wild 2 to Earth in 2006. The European Space Agency's Rosetta mission was the first spacecraft to orbit a comet, 67P/Churyumov-Gerasimenko, and studied its composition, structure, and activity for 2 years before landing a probe on its surface in 2014. Importance and impact. Comets have played an important role in the development of life on Earth. It is believed that comets delivered water and organic molecules to the early Earth, providing the necessary conditions for life to emerge.